is this irresistible creature who has an insatiable love for the dead?
That's right.
Jay, you're on with Rob.
Hi, Rob, Laura. How you doing?
Yeah, it's happening.
Where are you speaking from today?
I'm in Hollywood right now.
Okay, what's up there?
A couple things. Right now I'm actually at this special effects house that is doing the effects for my next movie, working on stuff and going over things with people. And I'm here rehearsing with the band, getting ready for the next tour, and editing the Tom Papa comedy special I shot.
Wow, yeah, you're a busy guy. It's kind of mind-boggling, but you're able to wrestle those things, huh?
Yeah, just kind of zing from one thing to the next.
Yeah, you're originally from Massachusetts. Where do you live these days?
I live in different places. I live in New York and L.A. I split my time between the two places.
Sure, I suppose you have to be in both places at times.
Yeah, exactly. I live on an airplane.
Hopefully, maybe you get some work done in between. I don't know. Does that work that way?
I kind of like use my airplane time to not work. It seems to be the only time that I'm not reachable.
Yeah.
You know, it's nice. Okay, for the next 6 hours, no phone's going to ring. There's no better feeling than when they say, please turn your phone off. Yes.
You're just finishing up finished up a TV commercial for Woolite, and the first half, did that turn out to be a movie trailer, horror movie trailer, kind of first beginning part of that?
Yeah, that was their concept. That's what they wanted. But the first half looks like a horror movie trailer, and the second half is like a more normal TV commercial with, you know, beautiful women marveling at how wonderful their clothes look.
Wow. Well, I'm trying to make the tie, but I guess horrors can be messy, right? Horror's a messy business, and maybe they want to use Woolite to...
It's a whole thing, yeah.
Something like that. What do we think of you in the rock, metal, horror, fantasy genre? So it's maybe not fair to you to not think that you can do some other things, directing the Comedy Central special. Were there any... Was it conventional, or do we see any Rob Zombie influence in that piece?
Well, I mean, I don't want to say it's conventional, because it's not. I mean, really, what the difference with this comedy special that we were going for is we wanted to make it look kind of classic. Because it's sort of a look to Comedy Central comedy specials. They're very bright and colorful, and, you know, the audience is very bright. And, you know, me and, you know, Tom Papa, who's special, his idea was in his mind, being a comedian, classic stuff seems like, you know, Richard Pryor on Sunset Strip, movies like that. So we took that approach, we wanted it to be a very cinematic sort of like concert feel movie as opposed to just another, you know, Comedy Central special. So it was a little more cinematic. And then we filmed these sort of bumpers that go in the beginning and the end of, they had sort of an old sort of vaudevillian feel to them.
Yeah, how do you feel? Did it turn out the way you had kind of envisioned in the start?
Yeah, no, it's turning out. I mean, we're still working on it, but it's going to be awesome. I'm very excited about it.
After the Hell on Earth tour, are we back to some of the Rob Zombie stuff we know you for? You start production on your sixth feature film.
Yeah, no, once the tour is over, that's going to be it for touring for quite some time, and then I'll go into full production on Lords of Salem. This is it for a while, because once I get into movie mode, that wraps me up for quite some time, so it's going to, you know, this is our last stretch of shows for a while.
Where does the Lords of Salem stand right now in production-wise? Do you have where are you in the process?
Well, we're in early pre-production. Like I said, I'm at the special effects house. They've already started work, because the stuff they do is so complicated, they start months and months before everybody else.
I see.
Then we'll go into, I mean, I've already been in location scouting. We're just starting casting. We haven't cast anybody yet, but we're starting a process. And then, you know, I get back from the tour, all the other departments will fire up, and we'll go into full pre-production, looking to, you know, start shooting it probably, you know, late September.
I see.
Wrap up sometime around Christmas.
Can you give us any kind of hint or tease about something in the movie, anything you're trying out, maybe for the first time, or something different?
Well, I mean, it's a very different type of movie for me. I mean, the movies I've made in the past, I mean, this is, you know... you know, this will be labeled a horror movie for sure, but it's very different. It's more like sort of a psychological ghost story as opposed to this a very physically violent type horror movie, which the other ones have been. So, yeah, it's a much slower paced, more methodical type film, and more in line with like a Rosemary's Baby or The Shining or something. It's more the vibe.
Maybe more of a thinker, huh, for the audience?
It's just different. It's a different, you know, it's a long, slow kind of creep out than something that's more explosive in your face. Although there's moments of that. It's just different.
You're from Massachusetts, so are there things from your past or home in mind for use as a setting or a location to shoot?
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, obviously Salem itself. I mean, that's where, I mean, when I was a kid, I went to, would go to Salem because, you know, they have the Witch Museum and all the stuff there. So that's sort of how it got stuck in my head. And, you know, we've been scouting there, and we'll shoot part of the movie there for sure.
Yeah, you guys have fun. You know, we'd like to think so. The fans always thank all their buddies, and they hang out in there. Does it work that way? Or?
We are. I mean, a lot of bands aren't. It's actually surprising. No, our band is really tight. We do, you know, I mean, these guys are my best friends in the world, and we do all hang out together when we're on tour, and we spend every, you know, we really do spend all of our time together, and we love it. And we, you know, when we're not together touring, we miss each other. But it is funny. You see how that we tour with other bands, and we go, God damn, those guys don't even talk to each other.
Yeah, exactly.
They completely ignore each other.
Like Aerosmith and some of their later days.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, it happens. I've been in bands when that's happened, but, you know, not like that now. This is a very good situation.
Well, we have a short time here, and we have to wrap up, but, good. All right, well, they tell me that that's my time frame, unless you have more time. And, new music, I should slip that in. What's coming up after you clear some of this other stuff for you?
Nothing for a while. I mean, once I finish the movie, then we'll make a new record, but that's not until next year.
There we go. Hey, thanks, Rob. Appreciate you talking with me.
Thanks a lot.
Goodbye.
This machine creates another theme so beautiful, they make you kill.